how do I know if biotin deficiency is causing my hair loss and my fungal rashes? Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind, or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
My question is around biotin level. So on an older podcast, I don't remember which one, you mentioned egg white consumption might create a biotin deficiency.
Right.
So given I have eaten 8 to 9 egg whites and 1 to 2 whole eggs as part of my breakfast since the early 2000s, I looked into that a little bit. And I do have a red patchy scaly rash around my mouth and nose that flares up periodically. That started in around 2006. And I treat that with ketoconazole cream as prescribed by my dermatologist. And that kind of takes care of it. But anyway, that plus hair loss, which may be hereditary, I thought maybe it makes sense for me to have a biotin test. So I did. And the results came back in the normal range per the lab's range, but it was in the bottom 10%. So I had this done at Boston, at Cambridge Biomedical in Massachusetts. And the test result was 492.5 picograms per milliliter in a range of 221 to 3004. So I wanted to see if you would be concerned about biotin deficiency in this scenario and what your view of optimal range would be.
It definitely sounds like it could be a biotin deficiency. And the plasma or serum biotin level is not a good marker of biotin status because it's not very sensitive. And so if you're in the bottom 10% of it, I would definitely take that as a red flag that you might have biotin deficiency. The best test for biotin, well, the gold standard for biotin deficiency is beta-Hydroxyisovaleric in the urine after a leucine challenge. I don't know how you'd get anyone to give you that, but the next best thing is to get a urinary organic acid test that has beta-hydroxyisovaleric acid on it. And I know that the Genova ION panel, which is the one I usually prefer, has that. But a lot of other ones do too. So if you get one, I would just check and see whether the beta-hydroxyisovalerate is on the list of analytes. I wouldn't conclude anything just yet, but I would keep biotin deficiency in the running for an explanation.
Certainly. Thank you. Are there any other, those are the symptoms that I had detected or just noticed or thought fit. Is there anything else in particular that you look for in that kind of scenario?
Well, had you not mentioned biotin would have been at the top. But there's a very strong overlap between, and I mentioned this in a previous question, is a very strong overlap between biotin, B6, omega-6 fatty acids, and riboflavin.
Okay. Well, thanks, Chris. I'll check into those tests and follow up. Thank you.
You're welcome. Take care.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount.
From now through February or March, whatever it takes to get it done, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for my consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book.
In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.